This is Radio Free Cybertron with your host, Brian Kilby, featuring Chris, Don, Rob, Diecast, John, and Melvar. For the latest Transformer news, reviews, and more, visit tformers.com.
This is Radio Free Cybertron, episode 397. Oh my god, can't believe it's 397.
How have we been doing this for so long?
I don't know. You know, back when
I guess it helps we took like 7 years off in the middle.
But you know what? If you average it out, we have a show posted every 2 weeks.
That's not that, honestly, the way some podcasts go, that's not bad.
Yeah,
that's pretty good, actually.
Yeah, it's like, we are on average fortnightly or biweekly.
I think we can live with that.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
We're basically like a paycheck.
Yeah.
Well, except that we take more than we give.
So, just like a paycheck.
That's true. Like, I haven't had anybody say, well, you've been around for 15 years. Why do you only have 400 episodes? Well, you know, at this point, that's not actually that bad. So.
No, it's really not. Because, like, a lot of podcasts are monthly at best. It's kind of uncommon to actually do what we do and get a podcast out every week. Basically without fail for, what are we on now, 6 years?
Yeah. Yeah. So
there you go.
Making sausage, I just want to point this out. If you're not doing your podcast every week, more than likely it's hurting your audience.
Yeah.
Consistency is a big deal. Okay. So I'm your host, mm-hmm. Brian Kilby, with me, XV, Melvar, Don, Diecast, and Rob Clay. Guys, how's it going?
Not bad.
Expensive.
Oh my
very,
god!
Very expensive.
It's an expensive day today.
Surprisingly expensive.
So what dropped in everyone's order? I had Generations Legends, Voyager, and Deluxe, the waves, the assortments.
Yeah, so like everybody who had Combiner Wars on pre-order got their orders filled, at least from Big Bad. So it just kind of depends on what actually you ordered. I only had Legends on order because I'm hoping to pick up other stuff on Hasbro Toy Shop and, you know, do a little bit better with coupon codes and stuff. But, like, everybody got hit today. It was kind of amazing to watch this, like, ripple across the internet.
It was Merry Christmas. We're taking, like, $170 out of your wallet.
Yeah, I had Chromia and Arcee in my pile of loot. And then I go to check on something, and it's like, you have pre-order products available.
So I
know, and I've looked, and it's like...
So I want to point out, if you can pre-order using either PayPal, which is great, or like a prepaid Visa, that's the way to go, because you just have $3 or something in it. It says, hey, is there money in the account? Sure.
Yeah, it'll decline, and then you can go pay with PayPal.
Then you go pay with PayPal. That's exactly what I do, because I don't want to pay with that card. I like paying with PayPal, but you can't pre-order all the time with it. So there you go.
I think if you are, like, you know, a long-standing customer, you can email them, and they can set that up for you, I think. But, I mean, in general, no, you can't do pre-orders and pile of loot with a PayPal.
Yeah.
Because the way I found out was I actually... people were saying, you know, Amazon was getting the Prime Voyager and Silverbolt in, and I managed to pick those two up. Prime was easy, and Silverbolt kept going in and out of stock, so it took me like 2 hours to order it. And I'm like, oh, I'm going to go on Big Bad Toy Store and cancel my... Oh, they're all there. Okay, I went back to Amazon and canceled from Amazon, just shipped them all from Big Bad.
Yeah, the way I found out was I got an email that said, your pile of loot has shipped. And then I got another email that said, your pre-ordered products are available.
Oh. I found out because I got a text from Diecast saying, hey, this thing came out. Look. Like, thank you.
So I think I was one of the first to find out because, like, Don, I got the email, your pre-ordered products are available. I'm like, what did I have on pre... Oh.
Yeah. So now I've got Chromia, Arcee, Silverbolt, Optimus Prime, the 4 Deluxe Limbs, and Power Glide. Mainly because I love that Power Glide, and I want to...
You're the girl that loves Power Glide?
He's the Don that loves Power Glide.
Yes, I am! I'll ask you to notice, of course.
Gosh, okay.
Can that be the intro for this episode?
Yes, it could be. So Chromia I got this past week, and right now I have Arcee on the way.
Me too.
Gosh.
Mm-hmm. Well, me too.
And on top of all that, as I mentioned in the pre-show, I have Quantron and Utopia in route.
How's your wallet doing, Don?
Thank God for deferred interest payments.
Mm. So it's not hit his wallet yet, but it will be in a few months.
Well, it'll be hitting hard for the next 6 months. So
yeah. Yeah. Well, enjoy those toys, Don, because it's the last ones you're going to get for a while.
Yep.
Yeah. But yeah, like, you know, this week, everybody got Arcee and Chromia and some Combiner Wars stuff.
And
we
possibly
just don't
even
have them yet.
Merry yeah. Christmas!
Well, happening. Possibly even the 2000... Like, last week, I got the the new RIT 2015 wave, so I'm like, oh, this is, like, the last 2 weeks have been a killer.
Well, I mentioned this to Diecast a while back. If this last month wouldn't have been so bad, but everything from, like, say, September or August kept getting pushed back and pushed back and pushed back. And for me, I have Soar, which is the fans' toy swoop. There's supposedly Sever, which hopefully we won't see, which is their snarl.
What about X?
Hmm?
X versus Sever.
Oh.
Game Boy Advance game made into a movie, or the other way around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
was that a game first?
It was supposed to, I think it was supposed to be a game first, but the movie came, I don't know.
So basically I've still got stuff that's from October and September that never came out. So I think everybody just got hit with the delayed blues.
I mean, in one way, it's cool that, hey, this stuff is out before the end of the year, and some people might actually be able to get, you know, for Christmas. On the other hand, hey, here's $200 worth of stuff that came all at the same time.
And also, how long is it going to be before the next batch comes out? So
about this time next month.
You think so? Because usually after January, it's going to be a drought for nothing new sporadically for several months, and now
about March.
I'm thinking like late January, middle February, maybe.
That won't be
for the first
bad.
Online shipments.
Yeah, it's just usually that after Christmas drought is just really just depressing as all get out.
Yeah. Hey, so Diecast actually already got his Arcee, and he's got a review up on YouTube. There she is.
I'm just doing this for Don.
It's a mass hallucination until I have one in my ears.
If you listen closely, you can hear Don gritting his teeth every time Diecast shows that.
I will be honest with you. I'm cruel, but I don't know that I'm that cruel.
I know, right?
If I had it, I don't think I would tell Don until he got it.
No, I'm just saying.
Well, no, I mean, like, I wouldn't keep it a secret, but I wouldn't be shoving it in his face every 2 minutes.
Don, did you actually watch
it? I would. That's just me.
Until I have it in my hands. It does not exist, and you are all the subjects of a mass hallucination.
Hey, Don, I don't have it yet either, so
yeah.
I'm Don, real.
Did you actually watch the review yet?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay, that's cool.
You know, I'm waiting for someone at Hadbro to show up my door and go, "Fooled you."
Yeah.
It's just part of the plan, Don.
It's all part of the plan. So this is the last live show for 2014. We will have one more show this year that will round out the last 2 weeks of the year, and it will be our huge, ginormous, large 2014 Year in Transformers recap. That's going to be something that we record over the weekend and have posted probably Wednesday night. So normally when you would go to watch the live show, we'll have the podcast and video versions of that available. And you'll probably be watching that early into Christmas morning if you start it.
And also something to give you a break from all that family time you'll be subjected to.
Yeah, screw family time.
Or at the very least, the MP3 version will be what you listen to on your way home.
Yeah, exactly. Or when you sober up.
Yeah, to keep
from same difference.
Yeah.
To keep from going to a food coma.
Yeah. So
I don't know about that, but no, staying over with family is just the process of sobering up so you can go home.
Yeah, pretty much. So that'll be huge. Not looking forward to putting the notes and everything together for that. It'll have to be its own thing because, my God, that took forever last year. But it was worth it, wasn't it?
Was it?
We have to talk about something other than third party this year, my God.
Did we
do a lot of third party last year?
We haven't talked a whole lot about third party this year, so there's not a whole lot to go back on.
Last year was all
third party. That's pretty much on purpose.
All third party, hardly any comic stuff, virtually no TV stuff. I wasn't watching.
Well, we still have virtually no TV stuff for this year.
I know. Hey, actually,
but there's a movie.
Oh God, I forgot about it. I repressed it. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We got to talk about that.
So, besides the RC and Combiner Wars, Melvar, get it out. Wait, we got these.
Oh, yeah, jealous.
Uh-huh.
As you should be, because he's awesome.
Yeah.
No, like, the Springer Wolf's really good to start with, and this is a great paint job on it.
Yeah. The paint's a little bit thin on the face on mine, but it's not terrible. So.
Yeah, I kind of have that, too. I think it's just, you know, the problem of white paint over darker plastic.
Yeah.
Yeah,
So on yours, the hood sections on the shoulders, can they just, like, do that? Because Springer could not do that. Springer had a stop there.
No.
Okay, then mine's a little bit misassembled.
Yeah.
Or just effective.
But as that goes, it's not really a terrible one.
Yeah, I mean...
No, I mean... Go ahead, Don.
To me, that's just... The Doom Buggy car mode I can kind of see, but I just can't see that as Rodimus. It's just,
look at the robot mode, Don.
The robot mode, yeah. The alt mode's just...
It really calls out to...
make it into a helicopter, Don.
It really calls out to IDW also. So if you don't have like a connection to that version of Rodimus, it's gonna be
something wrong with you.
Yeah, he does look like the robots in disguise.
More than meets the eye.
Oh yeah. So yeah. Sorry.
But no. Like basically, like the way I've decided to reconcile it is just that, you know, the giant car vehicle mode. It's Rodimus Prime without his trailer.
Because
that makes it fit in.
So it's Masterpiece Rodimus Prime.
He looks really nice. He looks really nice standing next to Masterpieces, by the way.
So he's kind of...
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yes, that does. That does work.
I'll be honest, it does.
Yeah.
Nice.
Also, you have your camera on a shelf. That's an interesting choice.
Yeah.
Well, that's okay.
I have mine on a cardboard box.
Some people have Elf on the shelf. You have a camera on the shelf.
Yeah.
You just make do with what you can, you know, get your camera in the right spot.
I canceled my pre-order on that, but I'm debating.
You probably should. I mean, you know, it's a hard hit at $90, but, man, it's nice.
I said basically, I'm sorry.
Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say basically you're paying third-party price for a first-party figure.
I'm looking at more like I'm paying BotCon price for, you know, an actual
figure that I want.
That's a great way of looking at it. I didn't even think of that.
No, I mean, Cloud basically is just like, you know, BotCon toys, but from Takara. And this Rodimus is the first thing. Like, this existed as art in the story pages long before we ever saw there was going to be a toy for it. And even at that point, I was like, I have to have that if they make that. They have to make that. I have to buy that. It's the first thing. The Starscream they did off of the Double Dealer remold of Blitzwing, if I can ever get that for like $35-$40, I totally will.
Oh, I'd pay $35 for it.
Yeah.
Hmm?
I'd pay $35 for it. Nothing more than that, though.
Yeah. But, you know, that Rodimus is probably...
I mean,
go ahead.
The Rodimus is the first thing I'm like, I will pay full cloud price for that. It's fine. I have to have that.
What about the Shockwave? Are you signed up for that one, too?
It's only logical. What a terrible looking toy.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's kind of the problem with Cloud.
Yeah, it's... Well, that Rodimus is the only thing even close to making me want to buy something, and it wasn't enough to make me pull the trigger on it.
You know...
That Shockwave is just absolutely just...
A thought just occurred to me. Have you guys seen the Facebook meme where it says, here's who to unfriend? You click the link, and it takes you to your friends that like, that crappy band. What's that crappy band?
Any of them?
Yeah, any of them. Mm-hmm. No, the one that Mike really likes that I give him crap for. Oh, you know, that really crappy band. So basically, though, if there was a way to like track who likes...
I don't even know Mike, Brian.
TFG1 Mike. You know Mike.
Yeah, I do.
But no, if there was a way to track people who like Cloud Shockwave, that would be a really good way of figuring out how to unfriend on Facebook.
The problem with Cloud in general... Okay, so like... We're in the third wave. There's one more wave that we know of, and that's probably going to be it. The first wave is just, you know, a classic Optimus and the GDO Megatron, but in G1 color, so it, you know, took away all the interesting part of it. The second wave was the Brawn they tried to make for GDO, and it got canceled. and that Starscream. So it's, you know, like kind of half and half on that one. And Wave 3 is even more polarized half and half because there's this really, really great Rodimus, and then there's Purple Whirl.
Sounds like a Dairy Queen, flavor.
I think I know why I didn't need that Rodimus, because I have a perfectly good Rodimus right here.
And I have two wonderful Fans Project Protector Armors.
I was never into the Protector Armor.
I have a Protector Armor, and I am much happier with my Cloud Rodimus.
For one thing, Cloud Rodimus transforms without taking it apart.
Yes.
That was always my complaint with the Protector Armor, because like, it looks nice enough when it's all put together, but it's kind of against the concept you have to take the pieces off to turn it into its vehicle mode.
And again, something I purged my brain to ban was Nickelback. Couldn't think of Nickelback.
Good for you.
Worst band ever, sorry. Just had to get that in there.
No, but like, Cloud is mostly miss with one or two hits. I really like that they're doing Generations Roadbuster as Energon Ironhide, just because Energon Ironhide was called Roadbuster in Super Link.
Oh, yeah.
I like that one. That's another one. If I could find that for about $40, I'd pull the trigger.
Right, and that's kind of the thing with the Cloud toys that are, like, you know, pretty good, but they aren't Rodimus. It's like, they're about twice as much as you feel like you want to pay for them.
Now, who's Roadbuster's case made again?
Hellwarp, which is Skybite and Skybite colors. Which is, it's one of those things that I like it as a concept. I don't like that toy, and I don't need it in those colors.
Yeah. Sort of makes you wonder what if they have that last wave. Are they going to pull out all the stops and make something like super impressive, or are they just going to have another?
You'd have to think too, like what mold would they pick? What I would want to see is Generations Rhinox in the Rally's Happy Meal toy colors.
Yeah, that probably won't happen.
I'm probably the only one who actually knows what I'm talking about there.
Sorry, I'm looking at the next news item, which I didn't know about.
Rally's Rhinox.
That's the exclusive thing. It was from a meal toy back in the...
Not a Happy Meal toy.
Yeah, I know what that is. I know what that was. So
I know, but you weren't paying attention.
I'm sorry. The Transformer Asia Kids Day Protectobot set for $13. Why did I not get that now instead of before? Sorry.
Actually, well, Brian, if you talk to Amazon, they might credit you the difference.
Okay.
How long ago did you buy it?
Like a week.
Last week.
Like last week during the show.
$23. I'm not too worried about it. Hey, okay, so that's the next thing. So whoever posted this, XV did the notes. So Diecast, you're officially fired as news director. XV, you're now news director.
Hey, I put this on there.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Yeah.
I won't make you update your business card, which you paid to print, which he paid to print, so I can't. I'm not going to make him change. It's a bogus title anyway. We're all news director. So the Transformer Asia, Asia Kids, Protectobot set, the one that is that comes with basically a Hotspot in Guard City colors. $13. Buy that. If you don't have it, get it. I got it.
And the other one's $13 too. With the
I don't care about that one.
Yeah. And...
No, the other set is just so boring looking.
Yeah, it doesn't have the Inferno mold in it. Yeah. So.
Well, it's not even that, though, because, like, you know, the two large toys in it are cast almost entirely in white plastic, and they don't have enough paint to offset that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, the toys look unfinished. I don't like to say that about stuff just, you know, offhandedly, but because the whole
unfinished thing is just a backhanded comment that fans make, and it kind of pisses you off. When it happens, though.
It's old fandom buzzwords, and I don't like using them.
Yeah, sorry, I interrupted you. I'm bad about that today. I apologize.
Well, we're all kind of doing it to each other anyway, so... No, I don't like saying that something looks unfinished, but when it looks unfinished, I'm going to say it looks unfinished.
You should. You know, call it what it is. But yeah, $13, definitely buy that. Let's see here.
Just never touch the helicopter. Trust me.
Yeah.
Yeah. The helicopter will destroy your soul and your love of toys.
It will. So this week on the show, 20, 4 minutes in. We're starting. We have the news, and this week in history, no Rob Springer this week, so we're not going to attempt to do this Q&A with Rob Springer. Though XV said we could Rob Springer up some answers, but...
Is it Taco Wednesday again?
No, he's he had a family...
Yeah, he's got some personal matters to attend to this week.
Yeah, so Rob, we're thinking about you, so we'll see you next week. Actually, no, we won't. We'll see you at the next year. My God, next year.
See you in 2015.
You know, that's 10 years after Transformers the movie is supposed to happen.
Mm-hmm. Why aren't we wearing those jumpsuits yet?
I wonder.
With our initials on them?
B, yeah.
Oh, God, Brian. The next, if we do a t-shirt again, it should be designed in the movie.
And instead of the initial, it just is RFC on the...
Yeah, the breast. Yeah.
That could work.
Yeah.
You know, if we pair that with You Done It Again.
Hey.
Like we could get this whole RFC wardrobe thing really moving. We would have to do polo shirts, though, because those jumpsuits were collared.
Yeah.
And on top of that, we could wind up right on the rack with Jacqueline Smith at Kmart if we try hard enough.
I don't think you have to try very hard to get into Kmart.
No, not these days.
You got to try hard to find one, but you have to try hard to get in there.
So, this week in history, December 15th, 1984, Heavy Metal War, one of my favorite episodes, actually debuted. And we actually did a Transformers Rewind about that, gosh, back in 2012.
Yeah, a couple of years ago.
Yeah,
and it was. I watched that, and it was so great and so odd to see JD again. Just
yeah, JD was awesome.
Yeah,
we'll talk more about JD next week during our review. Part will be a bummer, but the rest of the show will be awesome. But got to give the man props. But yeah, gosh, that means Oh, and the 30th anniversary of Combiners in the U.S. Oh yeah, that was Devastator's debut episode, wasn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah,
mm-hmm. yeah,
yeah. Very appropriate that 30 years after that, our actual updated Combiner stuff that's actually good is now actually coming out,
but not Devastator yet.
No, but that'll be the end of 2015.
Yeah,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. We assume. We have strong reasons to believe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's going to be the next Metroplex.
The internet's told us.
Yeah, the internet. The internet
it must be true.
But yeah,
he's healthy.
But yeah, we'll link to that episode of Transformers Rewind. That was fun. One of my favorite episodes. I really love that episode. That's to me, it's one of the more quotable episodes.
Well, and I think there's not a lot you can say is reason behind G2 and its episode choices. But I think there's a reason that was, the second episode of G2.
Yeah, it's the most awesome, season one episode, pretty much. Mm-hmm. It's pretty darn awesome.
I know, the Ultimate Doom's pretty good, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, that took three parts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Heavy Metal War is awesome all in one.
Yeah, but as far as Ultimate Doom, don't question the science. It'll drive you mad.
Well, yeah, I mean, that has to be kind of like a preconception going in. Don't question the science.
For Heavy Metal War, don't question the logic of not having Megatron with all their power chip rectifiers, all the time anyway, because, or, just make more, and then everyone would be, a superhero or a supervillain Decepticon.
You'd be like, we've done this once, we can't do it again. True. I don't care if it worked, we gotta try something else. But it worked, no, we can't do it again.
Yeah, my abilities come from a chip, not the jackhammer arms that I have, or the gun on my arm.
Well, the chip lets you make the jackhammer arms.
Yeah, God.
See, it's like how the transformation cogs were in Transformers Prime, where when they were removed, they couldn't even form their weapons.
Yeah, that hurts.
It makes perfect sense when you think about it in the context of fiction that was produced 28 years later.
Something they didn't stay up late writing. Yeah,
the look of pain on Melvar right then was just completely worth that too.
Actually, speaking of pain, guess what died this week? Transformers Universe.
I have two words to say. I was
saw
shocked.
That coming.
Good job, schmucks.
I don't want to admit this. I don't want to admit this, but I'm still kind of butthurt that I couldn't get in the beta because there was an issue with
Did
my
they
account.
Ever get out of the beta?
Well, the early the pre-public beta, and because there was an issue with my account that they never fixed, and I just completely ticked off about that, and they never did it, and I played it once, and I didn't like it. So I hate it because it's not good when anything goes away like this. I was surprised. I honestly was surprised. I wasn't expecting this to go down, but I haven't been paying attention. Apparently, they were releasing another product simultaneously or something like that.
Well, and they'd laid off, like, a bunch of the team on this also. So the writing was on the wall already.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Transformers are all dead.
It's just a little bit...
At least the universe they are.
Yeah.
It's just a little bit absurd that it was playable by the public for maybe a couple more months than it was years in development.
Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they spent 3 years making this game, and one of those years remaking it from the ground up, and people got to play it for about 6 months.
Uh-huh.
I've had that.
Yeah,
I've had that sheet from BotCon 2012 that has my character on it.
Well, treasure that because soon there'll be all that's left.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I have a character name like that too. I got it from New York Comic Con somewhere. I didn't even know. I mean, I guess I kind of knew the game was live, but there wasn't a whole lot of. They didn't email me to say like, "Hey, go here, play the game." Nothing. It was just like they didn't even want to try to get us to play it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it sure worked out that way, didn't it?
Yeah. No, I just wonder if, like, you know, did they spend so much time making this and put so much into it and then have to do it all over again? And it's just like, you know what, we don't even want to deal with this anymore. Let's just let it go for a little bit, and then we're just going to write it off and close it down.
That's why you let things do like that sometimes, so you can write it off. Not saying that wasn't the intent, but...
I almost wouldn't be surprised if Hasbro said, okay, well, you know, you took so long, now you can update it for Robots in Disguise, or you can stop. And they chose stop.
I wouldn't be surprised by that either, really.
I was surprised that they're actually refunding people's money.
For the Founders Edition, yeah. I'm not.
Actually, they're refunding more than, like, they're refunding other paid elements also. Not just the Founder Pack.
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay.
Considering, you know, probably two or three people ever bought a Founders Pack, you know.
Well,
don't
I just assumed
that out of petty cash.
I just assumed, like, once you develop the game, you could theoretically let this game just sit on a server and let the five people that are playing it keep playing it forever and ever and just never update the game and not, you know, not have to refund money or anything
still have to
like
be,
that. So.
There's still the cost of the servers. It's not a trivial thing. It's not like this is setting up. I'm just assuming, but I'm certain it's not sitting on some sort of virtual server somewhere. So they have real machines, they have real power consumption, they need real administration, they need, you know, all of this stuff, so...
And the thing is, like, if the shutdown was not so near to the public launch of it, you know, they probably could have developed a final patch that was like, okay, run this, and, you know, you can set up your own server and keep playing if you want to. Like, it doesn't have to go through our servers anymore. This patch, just, you know, play it, do whatever, we don't care anymore. This is out of our hands.
I would say it would be more likely for something like that if you had a client and server sort of deal, but this is really a server-based. I mean, like any MMO, it's really more server-based than client-based. Not that there's not a client, but it's...
Except it's not even really an MMO. It's, you know, a battle arena thing.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to have, like, a super ton of infrastructure... to make a server work, I wouldn't think.
And there may have been, like, some sort of ongoing deal with Hasbro that as long as this runs, you get paid so many dollars. And
yeah,
if they
quite possibly.
And if they allowed that to happen, I don't know. It's just conjecture. But.
That's entirely possible. It may be that it has not paid off enough to be worth renewing the license.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, you gotta just take the hit.
Wow. You know, they were probably counting on things like the Founders Pack and other paid elements... to really, like, push this forward into its second year.
If this
or,
game,
you know, all the way through its first year.
If the game had come out in 2013, maybe...
It would have had a shot.
It would have had a shot, but it's by this point.
Yeah, like I said on Twitter yesterday after this came up, you know, if they hadn't spent 3 years making and remaking this and actually launched it when people still cared about it, maybe this wouldn't have happened.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Stuff sucks. Let's see here. Speaking
Transformers of... Universe sort of did.
So I was gonna make a joke, but I don't mean it. Because I think it looks good actually. Masterpiece Ultra Magnus. We have new photos with G1 Magnus. And I think it looks great. It looks so much better than Citizen Stack. It's like ridiculously better looking than the Citizen Stack.
Well, you know, I've got the Citizen Stack, and I'm.
I do too.
Yeah,
I got Die Stack.
Yeah, you got Die Stack.
Same toy.
You know, I'll be honest. You know, the whole thing with the legs was always confusing me, because the initial picture showed, you know, it was just like red legs, like boots stuck, like legs stuck in boots, and then they added the covers to make it a lot better. Then there were pictures that showed no covers, so it was sort of confusing, you know, what they were shooting for. But it looks a lot better in these photos than I've seen in the previous photos.
Yep. I want it. It's pre-ordered through HOJ.
Well, it should look good at this point, since it's coming out in like a week and a half.
I know. Yeah. I'm just saying, you know, the pictures that made me not like it, I'm glad they changed.
Oh, God, that's more money.
Yeah, there's another pre-order.
After I got Citizen Stack, I dropped my Ultra Magnus pre-order, because I was happy enough with Citizen Stack. But if this does get a U.S. release next year, I'll definitely pick it up. Or if I see it.
Quick, XV, when's Star Saber coming out? Kick me while I'm down.
March. Yeah, I'd rather put that money towards January Star 4th. Saber than Ultra Magnus.
March is Star Saber.
Yeah, March 15th, I believe.
Yep.
Not January 4th. That's my grandmother's birthday.
And I can actually beat y'all, guys. Between me not getting Magnus, I'm not out of the woods yet, because I have Solid Shogokin Galgengar on order. So.
And anyway, Don, it doesn't matter if you drop your pre-order, because I don't think you're going to have a big problem getting a Masterpiece Ultra Magnus later, even if there's not a U.S. release, which I don't think there's going to be anytime soon.
There will be a U.S. release.
But not soon.
I will lose to Brian Kilby if there is no U.S. release.
Well, I hope there's never a U.S. release.
Well, you know, the last couple of years, there's been two Toys R Us, Takara, or at least two high-dollar releases. There was the Year of the Horse Optimus and Year of the Horse Megatron. There was Soundwave. There was Acid Storm. And so forth. So if they're going to do Devastator, they may do the Magnus at the same time. Again, just the grouping of two. I don't know.
Well, they've been doing two Masterpieces at a time. I mean, we got Soundwave and Acid Storm, and this past year we got Prowl and Sunstorm.
Grimlock.
I just picture one of the U.S. Masterpieces next year being Bumblebee and Spike in a ridiculously huge box
for $75.
Uh-huh.
That hurts.
And that's before the bump up. No, if Masterpiece Ultra Magnus is going to happen in a Hasbro release, what we would find out about that at BotCon, or maybe SDCC at the latest, because we found out about MP10 at BotCon.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, just hours before Kilby was going to buy a Japanese MP10 for three times as much money.
Not hours, like minutes.
So
oh, well, damn.
Yeah.
Do you think the U.S. release would be more toy color accurate?
I think it'd be exactly the same.
I think it would be exactly the same.
Because the Magnus is not that very, unless you do the Diaclone colors, or if you did Killing Jar colors. I mean, Magnus is still blue, white, and red in some base combination.
Pretty
I'm just looking at the comparison photos, like
Magnus is blue, is really dark.
Yeah, and G1 is very light.
Now, you know, Sunstorm, they did modify its colors between the Takara version and Hasbro's release, so it's possible they could change the blue on Magnus if they're that concerned about it. I don't think they will be.
Yeah.
But I don't think there's any difference at all in Prowl, is there?
No.
There's a sticker difference or something. That's
yeah, there's no significant differences in Prowl.
Nope. Not as far as I know. Yeah. Don't have it, though. Got my Takara one. I would, you know, on those, I kind of feel bad, because I would like to support Hasbro and just buy the Hasbro version, but they don't come out first, so I don't get them.
They come out like a year later.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, and like with the cars, they don't come out first, and because of the way they have to be made, at the time there was no good reason to think they would come out because of licensing.
Yeah.
Oh, true. Yeah, true.
And there's no way to know if they're even going to come out.
It's not like, you know, an MP10 or a Seeker or something where, you know, they've done this before and it's fairly probable, this is going to get a release even if it is 8 or 10 months later. or 2 years sometimes.
That's one of the reasons I think we will get an Ultra Magnus US release, because they don't really have to deal with the licensing issues as much as other cars.
Yeah, it's very possible.
It's easier to get to retail.
Plus their only other choice of taking a ready-made product to have a big-ticket item would be Star Saber, which has minimal recognition.
But what about the Starship license that they have to get, you know, for that?
It's not the Enterprise, so I don't think...
No, it's like a space jet.
Plus, with Magnus, even if you do get him as a Toys R Us exclusive, he's not going to be that much cheaper than what you can get him for if you're importing him.
He'll be $125 to $150.
Yeah.
Yes.
Plus, they can also cross-sell with their Prowls if they have any left.
I was just going to make that point. They can release two more of the Autobot cars next summer and advertise Magnus coming out, and that, you know, they all work together.
Exactly. So that way you've got... It may be
We're
the
awesome
same
tonight,
mold.
Don.
It may be the same mold, but if those are different enough colors and characters that you wouldn't mind having a second version, like Smokescreen being radically different than Prowl and Bluestreak. Plus, if you've got Magnus there, boom, you've got the whole shebang.
Yeah. Oh, let's see here. Let's
or,
see.
You know, when they bring exhaust out at Toys R Us.
Yeah. You can use your exhaust with your Masterpiece Ultra Magnus.
So, guess what?
I think you're just blowing smoke on that one, Doc.
Oh, God. So, G1, the Transformers cartoon, the Transformers leaving Netflix the end of 2014, which is in
I think
G.I. weeks.
Joe's going with it, too.
Oh. Mm-hmm. But they don't have the Deke series, so I don't really care so much.
Now, if I hadn't seen all of these, so I haven't got Netflix yet. I'm gonna have to pick it up for some shows next year. But I have seen G1 so many times. It's just.
But this isn't like a 13th generation VHS tape.
I have the Rhino videos right over there.
I have the Matrix box set. I'm good. So.
I have the Rhino videos too, so I feel
like
your
Netflix
pain.
Was actually a better copy than what was on Rhino, because they didn't use Rhino.
The Rhino version sucks, yeah.
Yeah. Well,
yeah.
Literally, I mean,
the Shoutmaster version. There's one of those, right?
Well, I mean, literally, having grown up with them, watching them, and memorizing them line by line, it's just after a while. I mean, I haven't watched any episodes in a long, other than Heavy Metal War on the rewind. I've just seen them so many times. I'm
in the same boat, Don. I haven't watched, other than when I do a rewind. I haven't watched an episode in forever.
I watched Autobot Spike yesterday.
I haven't watched anything recently.
But now I will. I mean, on the rare occasion I'll pull out, I'll watch something like God Gambit or Starscream Brigade or Make Tracks, you know, just something for...
You mean Make Tracks? Sorry. But yeah, so if you have been meaning to watch it, I guess you need to go ahead and do that. So
that's a good thing to do for Christmas when there's nothing on TV.
Does that mean that Jim is going away too?
I'm not sure. I don't know the complete library that's going, because, you know, the G1 cartoon, the thing that's, like, directly relevant.
The Shout Factory box set's only, like, $50. I don't have it.
Gem is not on the list, because the list is in the article of T-Formers. So.
Okay.
The Shout Factory box set is $50, and it's, like, the best quality G1 you can get.
That you'll ever get, yeah.
Don't tell me that. It's the best-looking episode of Bot you will ever see.
Well, then that's not saying much.
No.
Well, I could have said it's the best looking current Gen C minor you'll ever see.
Yeah. So,
but I will say this: as soon, I'm hoping they'll put Visionaries up on Netflix if it already isn't, because that'll be a sure sign that we are getting that reboot that they've talked about with trademarking new product.
Oh, so they're currently out of stock, and it looks like they'll have more in on Amazon soon. Which reminds me that I need to check. Amazon because I also have the Transformers vinyl record on order, which will ship next week. God, I have too much time.
Oh, that's the one that I found for $2 at my comic book shop in Bloomington.
Hey, so
right, but this is a new printing though, so it's actually like, you know, you can listen to it.
Yeah. So you should probably go ahead and order that on a DVD. So what I want them to do though is remaster from the Betamax and put it on Blu-ray, because I want it to look just like the cassette. The original cassette, I want it to look just like it. Perfectly just like the Betamax tape.
Chris, okay. are you the only one hearing Fort Max screaming in agony right now by converting a VHS to RIC?
The source is Betamax, Don. That's where the stuff comes from.
I know, but I'm just saying, I'm just imagining him, no up converting, no nothing, just a direct copy from VHS. I'm just imagining
it's the truest copy. Fort Max would want that. It's the truest possible representation of the original source. So I think that's exactly what he would demand, really. So
I don't see him taking that very well. I'm sorry, maybe I'm wrong, but...
Moving along. Let's go ahead and jump to the next item, which is... I haven't seen this, I'll admit. So, XV did all the show notes, and he did this news item. This is linking to... Oh, sorry, I clicked the wrong story. So, the Premium 3A announces Transformers Movie Bumblebee Premium Scale 15-inch figure. It looks nice.
It does look nice.
It looks as nice as a movie Bumblebee.
Right, it looks as nice as the movie Bumblebee possibly could.
Yeah.
This might replace my Human Alliance Bumblebee as my default Bumblebee. How much is it?
It looks expensive.
It's 3A.
It's 3A, yeah.
If it's 3H, I would get it.
3A. Like,
3A is one of those league of, like, high-end replica figure kind of things. Like, you know, all the Hot Toys Avengers
figures,
stuff like that. This is another one of those kind of companies. They do large-scale, high-end action figures, and they're expensive.
It
looks really nice, but...
It's pretty.
It's $380.
My Human Alliance Bumblebee will remain my de facto Bumblebee, then.
Well, now, it's still cheaper than the regular price of Gigantic Action Scorponok.
But not the sale price, right?
Oh. Right.
Well, no.
God, I still want that thing. Oh.
Gigantic Bath Toy Scorponok.
Well, I mean, you know, apparently it's a lot of the parts are rotocast to keep the weight down, so it kind of is like a bath toy.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
So I've got Kim now in the habit of calling those really cheap $10 thin Hasbro figures that they do of, like, Transformers and Star Wars and
the Titan figures, they call them.
Yeah, now because of Rob Springer, we both refer to them
as shampoo bottles.
Yeah. we were at Walmart like a couple days ago, and I'm like, oh, here's one of the shampoo bottle Optimuses, and she's like, I know what you mean now.
You know, I just not getting off on a tangent, but I don't know. Are those doing well at all?
They're big, kids probably like them.
I mean, it's just,
they're big. They sell for $10 or $15, and they probably cost about a quarter to make and, like, package.
Yeah, I'm just one with the margin. I mean, they're in every line that Hasbro's doing to some degree, except maybe My Little Pony. I haven't seen one from My Little Pony. But I just can't.
Oh, wouldn't be a little anymore.
I don't know that My Little Pony would work since they're, you know, four-legged and they don't really fit the...
I'm just saying that where they can put the Titan class in, but it's in so many different sizes and it's everywhere. So is it selling that fast and replenishing that fast, or is it just that many different molds they're making and putting it, because it's just everywhere?
They're multiplying.
It's just sitting.
You have to remember, too, like, you know, a Transformer has several different molds for a single figure because of all the parts. These have very few parts, so, you know, they only have to run, like, one set of molds per figure. It's a lot cheaper.
And I bet some of the stuff actually just pops in together, too. I bet there's probably less involved in
the assembly.
Yeah.
You know, in about five years, the toy bins at the Goodwill outlet are going to look like an episode of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Yeah. God, I love that place and hate that place at the same time.
I just wonder if they're not shooting themselves in the foot by spending more money on these Titan class figures.
They aren't hardly spending any money on these, Don.
That's the point.
And the factory that probably produces them is probably, like, really cheap.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't think they're coming out of the same factories that are producing, like, normal Transformer figures. No, these are cheap enough to produce that. You know, they can afford to have the stuff just kind of wait until it does sell, and it sells.
Mm-hmm. I see your point.
And let's see here, real quick. Platinum Edition G1 reissue.
This just came out this afternoon, actually.
Yeah, we were all surprised by this.
Yeah. Nobody knew
not
this
nearly
was
as
happening.
Much as we were surprised by the Combiner Wars stuff hitting, but that was more of a financial surprise.
Yes. We were surprised by this. Our wallets were surprised by the Combiner Wars.
Yeah.
So we have photos of the Insecticons three pack Generations box. Platinum Series box set. Actually, I guess it is Generations. It says Generations. So can you have Generations Platinum Edition? I didn't realize that it was the same line.
Platinum can be anything because, like, there's Platinum Age of Extinction, too.
True.
And since they've kind of reorganized things this year into Generations being pretty much the catch-all term for adult collector toys.
Right.
That it makes logical sense that Platinum Edition would be there.
Very true.
The other thing, too, is remember Soundwave at Toys R Us? That was sold in Classics packaging. And then Perceptor and the previous reissue of these Insecticons was sold in Universe packaging. So, you know, they're kind of going with whatever the collector line is.
Yeah, that's true. I just looked back and confirmed my box set is Universe of the Insecticons. Oh, yeah. Oh, so now that I'm not looking at my phone, I can see the picture of the Coneheads. I didn't see that before on the box of the Insecticons. So, yeah.
I have to say, I love the box artwork.
Yeah, it's nice.
I think that's the art from the Transformers Universe game.
Really?
I think.
I didn't play it so I wouldn't...
It might be the Legends card game.
Right, that's what I was thinking of. Sorry, I've got the dead game on the brain.
I mean, the reason this shocked me is because, first, they did it in 2009, and we've kind of gotten out of that reissue of G1, you know, G1 molds. And plus, we're getting the Legends, Insecticons now, so Bombshell's actually shipping with that Combiners Wars wave. It's just, it seems a little out of place or a little 10 years ago for this set for me.
It's also the fact that we had no, when's the last thing y'all remember that showed up with no advanced info at all? It just
I know one right off the top of my head, but, you know, I proved that earlier. No, RID Powerizer Megatron showed up in stores in England before anybody ever knew it was going to exist.
What about the Sharkticon Megatron? I don't remember seeing.
I want to say that showed up in eBay auctions before it hit stores. Like test shots of it.
Yeah, I think you're right. Because, I mean, you know, this, I have not seen anything on this on any website. No Twitter feed, no Facebook posting. Nothing.
No, this is the first information there has been about it.
And the thing is, though, since they're pre-existing molds, it's not like...
it's really easy to just run a set of them and get them done quickly. You don't go through the test shot phase and everything.
Yeah.
But if the price is manageable, it'd be nice to have Insecticons with good chrome again.
The previous release of these was about $35. These are Platinum Edition, and the price of things is different. They're going to be more than that this time, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know what your threshold is, Don, but, you know, I'm thinking like $45 to $50 for this set.
It kind of makes me sad. They're not worth that.
Do you think these are going to sell? I mean, like I said, you can get, you know, the three Insecticons as Legends figures for like $30. That would have been a great box set if they would have done a box set now of all three.
Yeah,
of
but
those.
These are for a different segment of the collector audience who wants the original toys, not necessarily, you know, admittedly really good updates. And we still don't have a Legends kickback either, so this is still filling one hole.
I'm just thinking that market is shrinking with the collectors because, you know, 10 years ago the molds weren't as advanced and we weren't getting as many of the the reissues, the really nice G1 throwback reissues that we're getting now, you know, in present day. So to me, the reissues were a lot more attractive 10 years ago than they are right now.
There's a couple factors to keep in mind with this. One thing, this could be produced primarily with the Asian market in mind. It doesn't mean we won't get it in U.S. stores because Platinum stuff usually does end up coming out one way or another through Toys R Us or Big Bad Toy Store or whatever. We get the same Platinum stuff, but some of it's still made with Asia in mind first.
And I will note,
though, that there does not appear to be any Chinese on this box. Like, four languages, of which English is one, but no Chinese.
Is it a deal breaker? I think the Combiner Wars stuff that came out in Asia first just has a sticker print, applied to the package with the region-specific information.
Okay.
And just to remind everybody, was it Protoman who put forth the proposition that China, as the economy has gone from everyone being poor to the, you know, they have a thriving economy, there's people with disposable income who want to buy the toys they saw as kids, which is exactly right. Where we were in the 90s and early 2000s. Yeah. So the price of third original stuff in that sense is rising, not necessarily on easier to find pieces like this, but especially in obscure or more Japanese series. But it's just, there's a market for this, maybe not in the US, mm-hmm. but definitely a market.
Yeah,
the market may not be the strongest in the U.S., but they're still going to take advantage of the market that does exist here. The other factor to consider, too, is that, you know, Age of Extinction's over. Age of Extinction was an outlet for a lot of easy Platinum series stuff, which they don't have quite so much of anymore. These molds are available. They're G1 reissues. You know, doing one here and there, it works out. And the other sets, the Seeker Squadron, or whatever they're calling the Coneheads on the cross cell, two of those toys were not reissued here the last time. So those are going to be new. That set's going to sell better than this one. But this one will probably do okay, too, just because it will be like probably 6 years by the time this comes out since the Universe Insecticons happened. You know, there's bounce back time, and, you know, it'll probably do really strong in Asia if it's going there, and it'll do well enough here, too.
So, I guess my question, it's only been 6 years, only in quotes, since the set came out. But there are other molds that they have. Why the Insecticons? Because it's a three-pack? I mean, you could do a three-pack with other things.
The Insecticons are insanely easy to get, too. They're some of the cheapest things online.
You know, Brian, I know.
But, I mean, they're not as desirable as, like, Autobot cars, I would say. Or...
It could be that they're the only things they have that are at a reasonable, like, balance of price point and, you know, complexity. Not too simple, not too complicated. That the molds are still in decent shape for.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Plus, I was thinking about that, Brian, while y'all were talking about the other things, is that a lot of people my age and the people that I grew up with, they didn't get as many Transformers because of the age or whatever the case may be, or people I know younger than me. But it seems like everybody had Insecticons. Yeah. That was the one you always wound up getting one of the three from a parent, a grandparent.
It was Kickback, is when I had.
That
Bombshell.
Yeah, that Trapple. Was, you know, mine was Kickback as well.
Hey, we had a full set between us.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So if there's any kind of nostalgia from these people that remember having this figure when they were young, they might like this set to get that figure back to sit on their desk. And if they have a kid that's age appropriate, they can give the kid the other two.
So Don,
and they'll keep this one for nostalgic purposes.
Don, you're exactly right. Go ahead.
And also, as we've just, you know, discovered amongst ourselves, it could be that people are going to go, finally, I'm going to have all three of those bastards like I couldn't have those.
Or you'll have all the clones too. So going back to what you said, Don, you're exactly right about people having only a couple. As a kid, I had about 20 or 25 Transformers. That's all I had. And for people not watching the video, I have my... webcam and I'm pointing to the back behind me. That's why I have all this crap back here, because of some sort of complex that developed, like an inferiority complex, because I only had like 20 or 25. Well, that's why I have thousands of these things now.
Well, I had to sneak mine in because my dad thought they were a waste of money.
He was right.
So I had to sneak mine in like my book bag or my pants.
Is that an Insecticon in your pocket?
It's a good thing.
That's a bombshell in your pocket.
It never would have come out.
Yeah. I'm just saying it literally. You know, if I wasn't coming home from school, I remember buying Brainstorm at an Eckerd, which was a drugstore chain in our area, for $13.71 on clearance.
My aunt gave me Brainstorm for Christmas. It's the only thing she ever gave me that I can recall, and I don't know why she gave that to me. She just brought it to me. May have been a secret Santa gift or something like at church, you know, as a kid. But wonderful.
But I remember bringing the Brainstorm in my coat because Dad was home, and it was wrapped up in my coat, and I ran right up to my room and hid it so he wouldn't realize it was something new.
Were you like 27 at that point, though?
Probably.
You're 17, right? When Brainstorm came out, like in 87?
17 or so, but yeah, my dad was kind of funny about stuff like that. Mom didn't mind, but Dad thought I was too old to be playing with toys.
He was right.
And like XP
we're too old
said,
to play with toys, but, you know, what are we going to do?
Like XP said, between these two sets, the Seeker set or the Conehead set, if they're the same price point, that's going to be the better value of the two sets.
I don't see it being the same price.
But no, there's no way those can be the same price point because when the Seeker molds were used in the commemorative series, those were $35 a piece.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
But now
the Insecticons are a lot smaller. Ago. So like you're looking at two different targets here. You've got a three pack of Insecticons, which is going to be, like I said, probably $45 or $50. And then that Conehead
$80 says, pack of Seekers.
I'm thinking 100.
I was thinking 150.
Now here's one thing though with those Conehead Seekers, is that not basically the same set they just released in Japan earlier this year alongside the three Autobot classic figures?
No, those were the original. Those were the Generations or Classics figures. These were the G1, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Because I was going to say, because if you want it, because that sits on clearance everywhere that I've seen it.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. If the Seeker Squadron was the Generations mold, then yeah, they could be the same price point as the Insecticons.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, this is supposed to be like G1 reissue stuff, as far as I can see.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And XV, I hate you for saying that two of those are ones we never got in the reissue because I don't have my reissues out and available. I just know I have all of them, so I would assume that I already had these. And now I have to buy them. Thank you.
Good job, XV. Good job.
I've done good work tonight.
Yeah. Hey, let's go ahead.
What can we get Kilby to buy?
I'm going to buy these, so you're good. Hey,
Melvar, you know what we have to get Kilby to buy. We have them right here.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, so we have more news. We have more news to get into, but because Rob's not here and we don't have a natural point to take a break, we're going to take a break in the middle of the news.
Unnaturally,
of course. And we'll be back here in just a couple of minutes.
Radio Free Cybertron will return after these messages.
Now, in the world of MicroMaster Transformers, the incredible MicroMaster Transport. MicroMasters, the only micros that transform.
MicroMaster Transformers, the most incredible micros of all.
MicroMaster Transport, sold separately.
You can hear our show on Stitcher Smart Radio. Stitcher allows you to listen to your favorite shows directly from your iPhone, Android phone, BlackBerry, or Palm phones. On demand and on the go. Don't have Stitcher? Download it for free today at Stitcher.com or in the app stores. Stitcher Smart Radio, the smarter way to listen to radio.
In the world of the Transformers, it used to be easy to tell the Autobots from the Decepticons. But now, the mini-spies are on the loose. They look like Autobots, but are they?
It's a Decepticon! After him!
Transformer mini-spies. You get one with each of the 6 Autobot mini-car packages. Motorized Transformers. You can't tell if they're Autobots or Decepticons until you rub up their symbol.
It's an Autobot!
Transformer mini-spies. Get them while supplies last from Hasbro.
Radio Free Cybertron has teamed up with Kokomo Toys and Collectibles in Kokomo, Indiana. If you're in the Kokomo area, visit our store for a huge selection of new and classic toys. Visit online at www.kokomotoys.com for our address and store hours. While you're there, check out our listing of pre-order items, as well as visit our eBay store. Visit us at www.kokomotoys.com. That's KOKOMOTOYS.com. We're also on Facebook. We now return to Radio Free Cybertron.
Okay, we are back. Let's go ahead and continue with the news. So we have a bunch of Combiner Wars news. My God, there's so much Combiner Wars stuff. It's kind of great, though. Isn't it awesome?
I mean, the simultaneous launch of, you know, 3 different classes of figures is huge. I mean, same day.
Yeah.
Just.
So we have photos of Optimus Prime, the Voyager figure. alongside the some various incarnations. The former, was that the Voyager size? That was Voyager size, wasn't it? The Classics figure.
Yes. Yeah.
God, he's so much bigger.
I really like how bulky he is.
Yeah.
I'm starting to like this, damn it.
I know.
Buy it, Rob.
I don't have to. I'm going to
review
it.
Prime was the one I didn't like.
Buy it anyway.
I'm like, he's just a remold Motormaster, and, you know, why'd they do Prime like that? And now I'm looking at it, I'm like, I like this.
Yeah, so what do I use for Tommy Kennedy? I need to figure that one out.
Well, I saw Goonies reaction figures today at Target. You can pick up one of the Goonies reaction figures.
Yeah, that would work. Those are $10, though. I don't know if it's worth it. But yeah, so he is pretty huge. Here he is with Armada Megatron. God, Armada Megatron.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Megatron was an Ultra, the equivalent of the time, wasn't he?
Let's see here. Ultra. Yeah. So, yeah, Ultra was the $20 price point. Yeah, or whatever it was at the point. Yeah, he is. And they are the exact same height, minus the inflation that, you know, Megatron has, which is the earpieces and the shoulder treads.
Mm-hmm.
My God, I love this. In fact, I think I want to create my own Transformers timeline or continuity or storyline where it basically has Armada Megatron versus G1 Optimus.
Well, I mean, you could use that Combiner Wars Optimus as Armada Optimus's pre-Earthform body because he has the chest window things then.
Yeah, or I could also use him maybe almost as Energon Optimus because he kind of looks chunky.
He's got the Matrix on the other side.
Yeah. God. I want this. I can't wait to get it.
I'm just hoping they redo the Stunicons in Autobot colors so I can finally get my mask ready.
Let's skip ahead a couple items, Don.
Yeah, okay, so
I didn't even notice that was a thing.
So
that's something I did not notice.
Okay, so I saw this.
We'll skip down to that and go back to the other stuff later.
So we have a few toys showing up. Is this which system? Which company is this? Walmart?
It's one Don's familiar with.
Okay, so new toys in the system. Protected Bots, blah, 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 blah. Mirage Prowl and Ironhide.
And Sunstreaker.
Oh, yeah, and Sunstreaker. I didn't even see
that. There's two pictures.
So, yeah. How about that?
Not exactly the Masquerade lineup, but close.
What they should have done here was instead of repainting Tailgate as Windcharger, they should have repainted Blackjack as Windcharger to go with that combiner.
Well, you can cram the Tailgate mold into Prime's chest cavity.
Oh, you can.
Like when you have the panels open, the space is just right. You can wedge the Tailgate mold in there. It doesn't like clip onto the docking nipples or anything, but it will stay. Had I not mentioned that on RFC yet?
I don't think so.
yes, last week you did. Yes.
Docking nipples is a new term that I am not familiar with.
I just coined it last week, Don. It's okay.
That is great.
No, but there was the pictures from the Singapore event where Windcharger was in Prime's chest. So, I mean, that it will sit in there, even if it's not designed to.
I still don't like that mold as Windcharger, though. I'd rather see the Blackjack.
Well, no. But for the Masquerade purposes, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is pretty great. Mm-hmm. So it's safe to assume that we have to assume that that's going to be the case, because Optimus... I mean, why not remove that gimmick from Optimus if you can? Which was what we originally assumed when this showed up at
Right. We saw Optimus before we knew Combiner Wars was actually a thing.
And then when we pieced together that Optimus and blah blah blah, why can't
Motormaster.
Motormaster. Brain fart. No caffeine. Not enough caffeine. Were going to be repaints that would probably also be a retool, which we know it is a retool, but that they would just remove the gimmick from Motormaster and make Optimus.
Yeah, because the way it went down was at BotCon, they showed Brainstorm, and they showed the Optimus Prime, and they were holding the Combiner Warrior stuff back for Comic-Con.
Thank you,
So all we knew Comic-Con. All we knew at the time was there's a new Voyager Optimus. We don't really like how it looks right now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I did. I did when we decided that it was Puppet Prime from season 5.
I know it took me longer to warm up to it, and a lot of other people also.
Yeah. But it's pretty.
I mean, it looks really appealing now.
Yeah. See, Big Bad.
Especially
can get
since it's an ultra height wall of robot at Voyager price.
Oh, let's see. Your Big Bad can get that to me in a few days. Amazon can get that to me Friday.
I sent you that link earlier today.
Mine shipped out Amazon, today.
Does Amazon still have that available at retail price, or is this scalper price?
Should be retail. Let me get back. Optimus Prime.
If it's $26.99, it's retail.
That's a generation. The Legends figure for $20. My God.
Yeah,
scalper.
$26.99 is retail. I mean, given the size of the thing, that that's pretty understandable.
I think suggested retail on the Voyagers is still $24.99. I don't think they've bumped that up yet. But okay. For online retail, add a couple bucks normally.
Yeah.
But no, there's been one store that works out of Amazon that's been buying the Combiner Wars stuff as it comes into stock and just flipping it back onto their own listings at a markup.
Of course.
Scalping without even having to leave your home.
There's one that it says ships March 2015.
I saw that one.
I don't understand that. I'm like, are they just going to take your money?
So they can list it as being in stock.
See, here's Optimus for $47.
I don't think that's retail price, Brian. Yeah.
I know that retailer. Probably should.
Yeah, me too.
Let's see here. Two new from 35. Yeah, I'm not seeing it.
Well, you can just go with Big Bad. It'll be fine.
Yeah, I should have bought it earlier, but I'll get it from Big Bad.
Probably.
Yeah, retail.
You'll get it after Christmas, though.
That's fine.
For all we know, tomorrow or Friday, Hasbro Toy Shop could also have these up.
True. Okay, but yes, so going back to the other story that we skipped.
Sorry about that.
Well, we had to capitalize on Don's masquerade thing because that was great.
And now I have a masky. I can't do it. Never mind.
Oh my God, Bombshell looks awesome.
Bombshell looks really good.
Yeah, God.
Power Glide looks really good. We had the pictures of that last week.
Yeah.
See all those people out there? They're here for you.
I can't wait for Bombshell.
There are additional pictures of Power Glide. We've been getting a lot of coverage on Combiner Wars stuff at T-Formers. If you go and search Combiner Wars, you'll find the whole listing of all the stuff we've been able to pick up and cover. Well, there's lots of pictures and video reviews that we've come across over the last couple weeks.
Here's Shrapnel against
Bombshell looks funny as a weapon.
Bombshell.
Okay, so... All right, so here's the thing with that. Bombshell's not designed to be a weapon. Because there's two packaging styles. Well, not exactly styles. Like, Power Glide's card, the bubble has a sticker on it that says it combines. And on the back, it shows Power Glide in weapon mode being held by Skydive, I think. Bombshell does not have that, and neither do the two recolors. So it's all under the Combiner Wars header, but only some of them are actually designed to combine. There's pegs and stuff on Bombshell where you can kind of fake it, the same way you can plug Thundercracker into Prime's docking nipples or cram Windcharger in there. But it's not made to do that. It's just a coincidence.
So XV got the sizing right on Superion, like dead on, so congrats on that.
Math.
Logic. Okay. He looks nice. He's the best looking so far. Of the two.
Well, and the thing is, like, it's the first decent-looking Superion
ever.
Ever, yes.
It's kind of amazing, because, like, they started the line with the Superion, and it looks good, and from all accounts, it is good. That's never happened. Superion has always been the launch combiner for a line. Power Core, Energon, and it's always been terrible.
So actually, I have
boring at best.
I have a Superion that looks pretty decent right here. It's the one of those Tuesday morning combiners. It's the
I guess there was the MicroMaster that was okay, except for how it fell apart.
This is G1, but he's shrunk.
No, I know. I was just thinking of that one.
Yeah, but this is the G1. Actually, I've got the MicroMaster one too.
One of those scaled down combiners from Tuesday morning.
The MicroMaster one is scaled up, The G1 is scaled down. Yes. But the G1 scaled down looks pretty good.
Do they
good.
Put in the middle?
Actually, let's look. Let me put them on video. Let me grab the other one.
Matches in checking.
No.
Yes.
Okay, I can't go away yet.
Look out, Don. He's going for your docking nipples.
Oh. That's what he is. He's trying to dock with Don.
Hey.
Is it safe, good. Don? Is it safe?
Be good.
Okay, so I'm gonna put the camera on me. So here they are, G1, Micromasters, scaled up Micromasters, scaled down G1. They're the same size. It's freaking
nice. Well, it makes sense. There had to be a point of balance in there somewhere.
Yeah, not bad. Hmm. Yeah, in this case, actually, the G1 looks better. Which is amazing because it's such a terrible toy in its original incarnation.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Superion.
No, 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 no. G2 Superion looks great. We forgot to mention that.
Well, yeah, but still, you know, the Superion design.
Yeah.
Now, if they do Combiner Wars G2 Superion, we'll be all set.
Oh, my God.
I want the Stunticons first, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, Superion obviously looks a lot better than Fall Cybertron Bruticus, and it looks almost as good as, you know, some of these third-party ones too.
Yep.
So I'm fairly impressed.
It looks better than Uranus. It does.
Especially Uranus, Don.
I don't know. Mine looks fine.
I don't want to think.
As long as I added on that add-on kit. That
well, Diecast, most of us don't look at our own. Most of us don't look at our own.
Oh my God! This is. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have gone there. Yeah.
I was trying not to, but then the door was just open and it just all came out.
Yeah.
But it's just for your.
Although the upgrade kit to make mine look the way it should is half the cost of the Hasbro.
Most people
figure.
Don't admit to having that kind of surgery either, Diecast.
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying you shouldn't have had to have bought that kit in the first place to make it look.
No, no, you shouldn't have, and like. We've talked about this on several occasions. I think we even talked about it at the live panel at ChartaCon.
Yeah,
it's one of those. Yeah. It's one of those things that keeps coming up because it's just like never should have happened.
It's just so dumb.
Yeah.
It's one of those things that's like this is like, you know, what's wrong with third party sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see here.
So moving away from Uranus, thankfully.
To Uranus, let's see. XV did the notes. I'm actually reading it. Blah, 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 blah.
Maybe you should read through these before we start the show.
I should. I don't always have time. But thank you for putting it together. Let's see here. So there are a lot of reviews at tformers.com in respect to Combiner Wars stuff. You should go look at that.
Really cool. I said that like 5 minutes ago.
I just reset it because that's where we are in the show notes.
You
wrote them.
But yeah, okay, so the Combiner ports. It's actually really neat how they've done this. You know how the Energon ports were and Power Core and all that?
Yeah.
And especially how Fall Cybertron Bruticus, where, like, basically it was all on the limb side, the functional part of it. So the functional part of this is actually in the torso. And what it is, like, we saw in the designer desk video that the plugs just slide down into sockets. What you can't see there is there's spring back clips. So when you slide it in, those flip over it and it holds it in a little bit. Apparently it's not such a tight hold that you can't like firmly hold the torso and pull up and it'll pull back on it, but it keeps it in so it's not gonna just like shake itself out when you're posing it or, you know, waving it around through the air like all adult mature collectors do.
Does it work better than, say, I don't know, Brainstorm's head master where Arcana connects?
By all counts, yes.
Good.
Because one side of this isn't painted.
Yes.
Yeah.
But no, like, it's really good. And, you know, for example, I've seen this done. You know, you slide the thing in there. It clicks into place. When you want to take it out, you just pull the thing back. Or you.
And he was Comcasted.
Actually, till he comes back. The way it looked to me is the part that XV's talking about, which is on the main bot, you know, the main figure, the center figure, is that little plastic piece. The only reason it actually slides up is so there's not a big hollow hole. So that kind of slides up and out of the way when you put the combiner port, when you slide it in, because otherwise they would have like this much of a gap in the leg, about, you know, a half an inch of a gap in the leg, if that piece didn't slide up and down.
Okay.
Now, I think Anthony was saying earlier in the week, or it was last week. Now, these legs, when you have for Superion, they can be turned around. It's not just a one-way fit.
Yes, they can.
Be turned around. Okay. Because for me, I've always done my Superion with the chest plate on the legs, on the lower robots facing forward, and the jet parts. It's just, that's the way it was done originally.
Yeah, T-Formers actually had pictures posted last week, and some of the pictures where the jets on the legs were facing in either direction.
Okay.
The one problem with that, though, is if you have the robot parts facing out, you lose the knee joint.
Yeah, I'd rather have it looking right than having the knees. He's not playing soccer.
Yeah, that's fine. And like, it doesn't matter what direction you put the plug in, because there's a swivel in there.
Okay.
So you can plug it in with the jet side out and then turn it around if you want to. You know, you've got the option, because that also works as the shoulder swivel when it's an arm.
Yeah.
Ah. Yeah, like I was trying to say before I got pseudo Comcasted, because I don't actually have Comcast. They've engineered a really good plug and port system for these combiners. I'm really impressed with like the base engineering all of this stuff is showing. That includes the hand and feet parts too. They put a lot of work into this. It's not the same team that developed Fall of Cybertron Bruticus, but they obviously learned from that attempt.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to make it as not FOC Bruticus as if at all possible.
Yeah.
Which hopefully, absolutely, with as much work as they seem to have put into this, hopefully that means we'll be getting more combiners as time goes on.
The other thing is, like, every report from everybody I've seen who has these in hand already, everything they've had to say is positive. Like, there has not been any bad reports on this, aside from, like, these guns are designed weird because they are, like, really big, long guns that don't seem to fit anything quite right. But as far as the design of the toys, everything is being reported good.
That's great.
Yeah, I am really encouraged by this, so I'm probably in for a big letdown when I actually get them in hand. But right now, it's really great.
Yeah. Merry Christmas. jumping to third-party news, we have...
speaking of a letdown.
Yeah, DX9 Toys, Plague, and Medilence?
Also like, a Dinobot.
Yeah. However you want to say it, I don't know.
Yeah.
But they're legends. Yeah, they're legend size. This is what Rob Springer was so excited about at TFCon, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know that I am.
Cool looking.
I thought that I was really going to love this, but I don't know. We'll see.
I think they're cool looking, and when you consider Combiner Wars, it's kind of neat having, you know, major characters in this scale.
This that Optimus is the Pen Optimus, so
yes.
Actually, those look pretty good compared to him. Actually, he looks perfect with those. And I bet each one of those will probably cost as much as the Pen Optimus does.
I think they're selling in two packs.
Yeah, the ones at TFCon was Blur and Ironhide.
Yeah.
For about 50?
Yeah, I think you're right.
So they're much cheaper. They're half as much as the Pen
Optimus. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, no, these are actually, as third party stuff goes, they're a fair value, I think.
So, my big problem with the iGear Mini Warriors is they scaled them up. I love the smaller ones, and at the $20 price point. So these are roughly at $25, but they look much better than the original
iGear stuff.
Yeah. So I actually am now changing my tune. I approve.
well, Brian, I watched a video, a video review for Gartnell and the Blur one, and there's some
Speedo.
Thank you, Speedo. and there's a lot of interesting engineering in the Ironhide mold that really makes it look, you know, well proportioned for that size.
Yeah, I saw that video too. The toys look really well designed.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah. Okay, I'm changing my tune. Are these available for pre-order? Or are they available?
I believe Scourge and Ratchet have gone up for pre-order.
Okay.
So look around for those.
DX9. I shouldn't do that while I'm trying to do the show. Okay, let me go back. So let's see here.
What you should do while you're trying to do the show is buy Cloud Rodimus.
Yeah. Yes, I agree. You should buy a Cloud Rodimus, Brian.
I believe the next news article would be complete IP theft.
This is.
Oh, it is.
Wait. These aren't official. These are like unlicensed.
Those are not official. I threw them in there because they're hilarious.
Holy crap! So, no wonder I've never heard of this company. Chinese toy brick company XSZ has released some unlicensed crayon type. These are like the. They look kind of almost like the crayon customizable ones that come with the. Extra accessories, but it's the Transformers Angry Birds. And are these actually branded Angry Birds? Let me get the bigger thumbnail or bigger image so I can see. Yeah, it says Angry Birds Transformers.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's out of China. What is anybody going to do?
Oh my god, these are. I want them.
That Prime looks kind of interesting. Yeah,
you know what? They don't look bad.
They will haunt my nightmares.
They don't look bad considering what their designs are.
I bet Don will get an Angry Birds Headmaster Arcee before he gets an actual Headmaster Arcee.
No,
you know, that'd be easy to do because you take off the head and it's an Angry Bird.
Yeah.
No, because I ain't gonna buy these pieces of crap because I don't like
them. We'll get you one for your birthday, Don. When's your birthday?
1813.
Birthday, not birth year.
I am not starring in Forever. I am not immortal.
From the dawn of time he came, moving silently down through the centuries, leading many secret lives, struggling to reach the time of the gathering, when the few who remain will battle to the last. No one has ever known Don was among you, until now.
If I was a Highlander...
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm a Highlander nerd. Okay. That's sad that I just quoted the intro to Highlander for everybody. Okay, I love Highlander, though. So, Mega Steel, MS-01, new test shot. So this is the Megatron that's a tank.
An H tank. H-ish tank.
So this is the one that we don't like.
That looks horrible. Looking tank.
Is this comic accurate at all, or is this out of nowhere?
It's
from
could be worse.
Stormbringer, was it?
Yeah.
I heard that wasn't well received.
If it's Transformers, I mean, some people are going to hate it. Like me, or some people will love it, and if it's from that, so
maybe in color it'll be a lot more pleasing, but
they're not the best test shot colors. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, it's like, hey, I'm sponsored by Poland Chainsaw. I'm all green.
Nice, Don. I appreciated that.
That's like me making an Eagle Man reference, though, Don.
So, there you go. Megatron. If you want it. Let's see. Here.
Looks interesting.
Yeah, I guess. Sure. So, also on T-Formers, Age of Extinction pushes Frank Welker to the top slot in highest grossing actor of all time list. That's awesome.
A lifetime of doing animal voices.
You. He's number one. Mm-hmm. I thought he's pushed into the top 10.
No, he is number one. He passed Samuel L. Jackson with Age of Extinction.
Holy crap. I mean, obviously he's been in everything. Mm-hmm. Stan Lee makes sense because of the Marvel stuff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
He's only been in 23 movies, but they've all made money.
Frank, but he's been in 106 films. The Sam Jackson's 113.
Oh, here's some on the list. John Ratzenberger.
Mm-hmm.
All he's done is Pixar movies since Cheers folded.
So yep. I will admit,
right? But he's done movies. Pixar movies.
I don't know who Bob Bergen is.
And he was in Empire Strikes Back.
Yeah, uh-huh. That's true.
Yeah,
who's Bob Bergen?
Good question. I'll go look.
It sounds familiar, but I can't place it.
Who's Harrison?
Ah, he's the current. He's the Bob Bergen is the current voice of Porky Pig.
Oh.
Wait, okay. Why would he be in the top? Why would that matter? What has Porky Pig done for us lately?
Space Jam?
Yep.
1996?
Let's see. Also in Gremlins, Army of Darkness. All three Santa Clauses.
There was a Gremlins, Army of Darkness?
No, I'm just... I did not
There's a comment
pause.
There.
Yeah. I did not pause
Tim Allen? Is that who that is?
Harrison Ford. Kidding. Wow, Frank Welker. Congratulations.
Yes.
I would have never guessed that.
Me neither.
You know that most awesome thing? We need to get Morgan Freeman to do the biography of Frank Welker.
Oh, I thought you were going to say we need to get Morgan Freeman to do Porky Pig.
That would be awesome, cool. Yeah.
let's see here. Oh, so I haven't actually looked at this. I guess I need to.
Put this image on the video if you can.
Yeah, Alex Mellon did a 30th anniversary image. It's pretty nice.
That's pretty.
All this year, IDW's retailer incentive covers have been 30th anniversary stuff. And this is what Alex did for Transformers, formerly Robots in Disguise, and More Than Meets the Eye.
So, wow. I love that G2 Megatron.
Who's RC fighting?
Arachnid, isn't it?
Okay. I didn't think of that as Arachnid for some reason.
Gosh. I think that's who it is anyway.
That's
pretty sweet.
That's who it is. Wild Convoy.
That's Overlord up in the top corner.
Oh yeah, there is Overlord with Grimlock. Yeah, it's nice. And there you go. Oh, Galvatron.
Yeah, there's Lyle Convoy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is this not a great image though?
Yeah, it's nice.
It is.
You know what's a great image? Does anybody remember that drawing that guy? I don't know. He had a vaguely Asian.
Crisis on Infinite Cybertron.
Vaguely Asian sounding name, like a Pat Lee or something. He did this thing for Wizard. No, I'm kidding.
Oh God!
I hate that photo. But that got so much.
But Brian, when you started, 10 or 12 years ago, somebody was doing this massive fan art piece, Crisis on Infinite Cybertrons, which was it. This reminds me of that in a way, but that was obviously with less stuff involved because we didn't have many separate continuities then.
Yeah, I'm trying to find for people. So what I try to do on the show each week is give some sort of context. And because there are people who've not been around as long as we have, there are people who've been around much longer, like Don. But not everybody.
But Don's one of us, so.
Yeah, Don is one of us.
That kind of throws off the curve.
So I'm trying.
I even it out. I haven't been around.
So Wizard magazine, they were trying to do this story about if certain things were brought back or whatever, and Pat Lee or their favorite cartoon, and Pat Lee did Transformers. And oh my God, the fanboys went crazy. It looked like crap. Mm. But ultimately, Dreamwave got the license to Transformers and they butchered it. But I'm trying to find the image.
Brian, at the time, though,
There's nothing. I get it.
To this day, I know there's perspective problems and there's other problems with it, but it is still one of the
management problems.
I would rather have my memories than have somebody pissing on something that I love. So, you know.
But you got
remember
those
Don?
Surprise.
Remember Don? They gave us MicroMasters also.
Best comic ever.
Well, I seem to remember enjoying.
It makes no sense.
Well, I remember enjoying the first two issues. Then just
you're
went,
high
you...
then, Don. That comic
you
makes
know,
no sense.
It's a little known fact, but they made Kronos out of pressed copies of MicroMasters.
Man, I can't find that picture. I wanted to show
I
that. Oh, here it is. Here it is.
There it is. Yeah,
I found it.
It's the one where now Megatron originally had the cannon on his wrong arm, and then they fixed it at one point.
What did they do? Just mirror flip the picture?
I don't remember. I just remember Megatron was wearing it on his. I remember. That was the only thing wrong was and at the time was
bring this up. Oh man. Okay.
Is that it?
It's being a jerk. Oh my God. Oh, this isn't this is linking to a GeoCities site. It's not really
that's not gonna work.
It's not really GeoCities.
RioCities?
It's OOCities. It's like fake GeoCities. Okay, let me pull this up. Here it is.
Well, Brian, is the one I put in the Skype link? Is that the one we're thinking?
I mentioned it before, Don. I can't see the Skype link tonight.
Don, can you paste it in the show notes then? Or maybe I can.
Yeah.
I got this up, so.
Okay.
Yeah. I remember his favorite character is Sideswipe. So he couldn't tell you a thing about him.
Right. Well, to be fair, if he's going by the cartoon, you couldn't tell
anything about him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he knows Jet Judo.
Yeah.
That's something about Sideswipe from the cartoon.
Yeah, and he has a jetpack.
He has a jetpack.
And pile driver hands.
Yeah.
Well, hey, is it me? Did Prime ever give him his jetpack back? Because I thought I remember seeing it.
I think Prime broke it.
No, I mean, I just remember, I thought I saw a couple of scenes.
They cut out the scene in the episode, though, where he hands him the smoldering wreckage of it back, and Sideswipe took his
And when he needed it again, what all Optimus did is he took Sideswipe and he, like, ripped him apart and he, like, threw him on his back and he threw him into space.
I mean, don't y'all remember at one point Prime still had it, one of the drawings was him. He was still wearing it a few episodes later. It was just in one scene and he was still wearing the jetpack.
Whoops. Well, that's G1 for you, Don.
Yeah, that's true.
You found an animation error in G1?
I know. It's amazing, I'm sure.
That's not the same photo, Don, but that one's pretty awesome. Bad, too. But, yeah, so...
I thought that's the one that was in Wizard.
No, it was this one right here. I am pasting... For people listening to this on the podcast, this is entirely engaging. But I just linked on to this photo of Pat Lee from 1999 or something, and it's just terrible. So there are reviews of Drift and Empire of Stone number 2.
Oh yeah,
Drift, Empire of Stone number 2, and more than why are they doing another Drift miniseries or Drift miniseries?
No one knows.
Yeah, I don't
killing
get...
time.
And I didn't even know about that.
Why did they let McCarthy do it?
I thought that was two separate books, and there's a Drift and Empire of Stone. I didn't even know about this. This is the first I've heard of this book.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Not missing much.
Yeah, and More Than Meets the Eye number 36.
So, like, when the Windblade miniseries was gearing up, Margaret Scott and Sarah Stone did this massive, like, interview tour and everything to build up publicity for the book and get people interested. Shane McCarthy did one interview, like, 2 weeks before the book came out.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's no reason you should have known about this because, you know, the author was not really engaged with spreading the word.
And it reads like he cared about that much, too.
I was going to say, he doesn't seem that engaged with writing a story, either.
Yeah. Don't know.
More Than Meets the Eye is fantastic, though.
Or paying attention to the character development that's happened previously.
Ah, well, in that interview, he basically said that he was just going to ignore what James Roberts did with Drift over the last, you know, year or so.
Yeah.
Hey,
as to make him into an actual character.
Right.
So, question. I legitimately don't know the answer to this, but off the top of my head, it seems to be the case. Not counting the UK comic, we are now at issue 36 on More Than Meets the Eye and the Transformers. Is that the highest that any Transformers comic has gotten since the G1 comic with Marvel?
I don't know the Dreamwave numbering off the top of my head.
Yes, because...
That's huge.
Yeah, it is because...
Right, because the previous IDW ongoing only got to, what, 31 or 32?
I don't think it got as far as that. I mean, as far as where we are now, so...
Right, and then Energon and Armada only...
I think 32 was Death of Optimus Prime, I think.
Yeah.
Okay, then the ongoing got to 31, then they reset the numbering.
And when they were doing Armada and Energon, Armada had just flipped Energon at 19 or 20 when that was canceled.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so the Generation 1 ongoing, Volume 3 went 10 issues, Volume 2 went 6, and Volume 1 went 6. So the first two, Volumes 1 and 2, are miniseries, and Volume 3 basically killed the thing, and Pat Lee didn't pay anybody, and it went bye-bye.
Yeah.
I haven't bashed Pat Lee in a while, so.
We're overdue.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. It's Christmas.
You know, New Year's about to start.
Okay, hey, if Pat Lee is watching this thing, pay your people so they can start the new year with some money in their pocket.
Yeah.
There's things I could say to that, but it could get us in trouble, so I'm not going
I don't want to get sued again. So what's I don't have anything else. Anybody else have anything?
No, that's pretty much turned into the end of the episode
awesome.
Right there.
So again, people watching live, this is it for this year. We'll actually not be back live until January 7th. That's the first. God, yeah, January 7th. That's a while away, man.
And then the week after that will be episode 400, won't it?
This is 397, 398, 399. Yeah. Yeah. So yeah.
January
14th. All right. Gosh. Yeah. So January 7th is when we'll be back live. But if you tune in live, tfradio.net/live next week or at tformers.com, we'll have the show, the new show up. You can pretend it's live. You can just like start tweeting to us and, mm-hmm. you know.
And if some of us are around, we will probably answer.
Yeah.
I'll answer. Yeah. I don't got anything else to do.
Yeah. So, follow us on Twitter at TF Radio and Facebook, facebook.com/TF Radio. And I am trying to get more stuff on our Google Plus page, and it's some long URL. All
right. So, I have a question before we go.
Yeah.
Because I can't let this go like 3 weeks. Huh? Whatever happened to that? Leader class Megatron that we saw that was going to come in two different versions. Are we still getting that? Wasn't that supposed to be out before the end of the year?
Well, they're supposed to be. That is supposed to be its own case assortment.
Yeah, they're both coming out at once. I thought, yeah, but yeah. I mean, I don't know when it was coming out. I never assumed it was coming out at the end of the year.
Well, I mean, they said it. They said it was basically going to be the second wave of Voyagers after, you know. After what we got,
second wave of leaders. Yeah,
leaders. So,
it should be after Jetfire, because Jetfire was his own wave.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Jetfire hasn't been out all that long yet. So,
yeah, a lot of people have never even seen it.
I haven't seen it yet.
Really? God, yeah. Jetfire's been everywhere around me.
Hey, I went back and rebought a boxed version. It was like $22 at Kmart on sale.
Yeah, I saw that.
Even Big Bad Toy Store and Amazon have been pretty much dropping the price on Leader Jetfire.
Oh, God, it is Leader Class. I keep forgetting that. Yeah. Like, I'm looking at it. Yeah.
Well, they kind of have to, though, because it shipped in a solid case. You're going to have tons of those forever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another Battle Unicorn.
That's why solid pack cases, even of the large toys, is bad.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That answers that, people.
Yep.
Okay, so again, we will be back on January 7th. God, that just seems like so long. Maybe.
Yeah, that's kind of a while, isn't it?
That is a while, but that'll give us a chance to get some other stuff done, I think. We have.
Yeah, right. Yeah. You say that,
I
but.
Say that. Yeah, I've got a lot on my plate. I've got a listing of like 50 things I need to do, like rebuild the website, blah, blah,
and
blah.
And maybe two of those will get done over the next 2 weeks.
You're being generous.
I'm thinking I'll get the website rebuilt in the next 2 or 3 weeks. Yeah.
No.
Yeah, I'm thinking I will.
we can rebuild it.
Yeah, thinking I will. Okay. So, guys, thank you very much. Hope you all have a happy or merry or whatever holiday that you celebrate or you choose not to celebrate. And happy new year and all that.
I choose to sleep Christmas Day.
Yes, and people out, there. So, thank you so much for joining us. We again will have our year end mega show here next week. So tune in tfradio.net, tfradio.net/podcast directly to subscribe to the show. Watch us on YouTube. Yada yada yada. We appreciate any and everything that you do. You're great. We do this for you and our egos. But mostly for you.
I do it because I have nothing else going on in my life. And I love doing this. So.
Yeah. I have a love-hate relationship with it. But I love it more than hate it. So I keep doing it. Okay. No, I'm kidding. I really love doing it. It's kind of nice, you know, having an outlet to spew nonsense and just go off topic.
Have fun.
And just be able to boss people around. Diecast! Go paint something.
Aw.
Okay.
Go to Toy Fair!
Go to Toy Fair.
Yeah, it's pretty nice, pretty nice. Sorry, I'm just milking it because it's going to be 2 more weeks. Okay. Thank you very much. We'll catch you later. Have a good one.
Everyone have a good Christmas. Take care.
Ho, ho, ho.
Happy Hanukkah!
This has been Radio Free Cybertron. Visit us at tfradio.net for show notes and to subscribe to the podcast. Follow us on Twitter at TF Radio for news and updates. Watch our live stream at tfradio.net/live. Join our Facebook fan page at facebook.com/tfradio. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, TF Radio Network. Have a question or comment? Leave it on our Facebook fan page or mail it to contact@tfradio.net. This podcast is released under a Creative Commons license. Any part of this podcast can and should be redistributed, but please, proper attribution is required if you know what's good for you. Radio Free Cybertron, the original Transformers internet radio show since 1999. 100% girlfriend free since 1999.